Hey guys, I'm Mia, welcome to Braidtastic. So today's tutorial is going to be the flower braid. A couple videos back, I had gotten a request to do some sort of braid that looked like a flower, and this is what I came up with. So what you're going to need are your basic brush and comb, and several clear elastics. You can use clear, that's just what I have. You're also going to need one big elastic, and then you're going to need several bobby pins. And then, this is optional, but I'm going to be using a spray bottle filled with water, but as said before, it's optional. So let's get this braid-tastic hairstyle started. Okay, let's get started. So what I've already done is pulled her hair into a mid ponytail, and I haven't made it too tight or too loose. And then I've just brushed out the ponytail so there's no knots or tangles. And then what I have sitting aside is extra bobby pins, kind of a lot, and then several clear elastics. So what you're first gonna do is just take a section, just a little section, from the top of the ponytail, about this big, and what I'm gonna do is just use some water and spray it down, and then I'm just going to do a regular three-strand braid all the way down to the ends. And then once I've reached the end of her hair, pretty much the end of her hair, I'm just going to take a clear elastic and I'm going to tie it off. And so I'm just going to take a clip and I'm just going to clip it out of the way. Okay, so then what you're going to do is just take a section from this side of the ponytail, about the same size. This is on the left side of her ponytail. And you're just going to repeat the same process. And as said before, I'm going to use just a little bit of water and spray it down. And then again, I'm just going to braid it all the way down to her ends. Taking a section from the bottom. So I'm just going to take another section about the same size, then I'm just going to have her hold the ponytail out of the way. So now I'm going to the other side of the ponytail, and I'm going to take a section same size from the right side of the ponytail. Okay, so I've just finished the last braid, and now we're going to be making the petals. So what I'm going to do is just take out this clip that I had before and just let all of these fall. And then I'll start with this first one on the top. And you're just going to make a loop like this. And this is kind of short, but that doesn't matter. And you can see this kind of small loop, but that doesn't matter. And I'm just going to take a bobby pin and pin the ends into place right here. I recommend using at least two just to crisscross your bobby pins, just so they have extra security. So after I do that one, you can see that I have that little piece sticking up. So I'm just going to take one and pin that down as well. And then you just want to kind of make it like a petal, and you're just going to do the same thing. Just take this other braid, you can do them in any order you really want, and then you just make a petal, have the ends, try to hide them as best you can, and then just take a bobby pin and pin them into place. now you can see I have these four petals that I've just done, and I still have this ponytail right in the middle here. So now what I'm going to do the rest of the way until I run out of hair is just take sections, and you want to try to do it where the two petals meet in the middle, and you're just going to keep doing the same thing, braiding them. And you can do four at a time, you can do five at a time, then you're just going to keep pinning them on top of each other. So it's going to kind of get like a daisy flower effect. So just keep doing that all the way until you don't have any more hair left to braid. Okay, so as you can see, I've done all the rest of the petals on her hair, and I think it looks like really super cool. And now I just have this one last piece that I'm going to braid now. Show you guys the very last piece. So just put it down. Gosh, I keep giving her the shivers every time I do that. And then just normally three strand braid. So Jessica and I thought that this wouldn't be very like wearable, except for like if it was like crazy hair day or something. But once we finished, we found that it looked like it was really cool, and that it just looked like a really intricate updo. And so I think you could wear this out in public to school or something, as long as you have kind of a big amount of time on your hands. It is more time consuming than some of my other hairstyles, but I think it's really well worth it. And since this hairstyle is so like elegant looking, you could probably wear it for like a homecoming or a prom or any kind of dance. I just think it's really pretty. It's really elegant looking. It's really cool. And like Jessica and I, we totally had a different vision of what it would look like, but it still looks really cool. I know, but it's just so cool. Okay, so then just this last little piece. You can see with some of them, I did like tuck the ends through just to give it like a cool look. Gosh, I keep saying that. And if you have any like rhinestone pins, they're like little pins and they have sparkles on the ends, I would just take it and twist it right in the center there. But we don't happen to have any. But I still think it looks really cool just like this. I hope it looks like a flower. I think it does. It looks like you took a big amount of time on it, which you kind of did, and it looks like it's really hard, but it's really not. As long as you know how to braid, it's kind of fairly simple. So I hope the one person that asked for this hairstyle really likes it, and I hope the rest of you guys like it. I think it's really cool. I'm sorry, I just have to say that one more time. So yeah, that's the finished look.